Alright, so this is another video response to Lpuro001 2 days ago. Has your emergency department ever considered hiring scribes? Scribes are in the old times of Plato, where these kids would sit down and kind of pretty much write whatever the person was saying. So in medicine, there has been increased utilization of scribes, people who act as transcribers, but not just transcribers of information. That's basically would be a dictaphone or something like that, and somebody just put in the data in. But scribes are really productivity assistants in the emergency department who follow the doctor around and enter the information of that encounter. So as the doctor is asking the questions to the patient about family history, surgical history, medications, they're just on the computer putting them in, which relieves the doctor from having to write notes down. They're doing all that for him. While he does the exam, he says normal lung exam, normal abdominal exam, or the abdomen, there's some umbilical hernia, and they're just putting into the computer system. But if you utilize them right, you can even ask them to go back to the patient, ask him about their primary doctor and what their number is, and call them to ask a question. They can fill out some paperwork, and then the doctor can just sign it. It really increases a doctor's productivity. And the question is, because I did a video log and how tough it is sometimes to work in the ER, where you've seen a lot of patients, and then you end up end of your shift, and then you have 30 charts to do. Yeah, I have little notes and scrap paper so I can finish them later, but it still takes 2 to 3 minutes per chart to finish them. So when you finish your shift, now you have 30 patients, 3 minutes each. That's an hour and a half worth of work before either you go home and do them later or stay at work and finish them. It says here you could save a lot of time if you have someone doing your charts while you see patients. This is absolutely true. I've worked in places with Scribe, and it has its pros and cons. The pros is, one, you almost always leave on time because your charts are done, and even if they're not done, the mid-level can finish them, and then you can sign them later. Number two, your charts are much more complete. You can make sure your EKG interpretations are always in. They can check old charts and import data. They can make you aware of things you were not aware of, because while you're doing other things, they're looking back at the past medical history or completing the note and say, hey doctor, I didn't see you comment on this. What do you want me to write? And the doctor goes like, oh yeah, I didn't ask that. So they're very, very useful, especially the very good scribes. They pull out old EKGs for you. They pulled up old HMPs where you find out more details about the patient. They're extremely useful and definitely improve productivity. But here's the deal. Nothing's without troubles. I just want to show, and hopefully it's being captured, the average cost of a scribe, let's say $15 or maybe $18 per hour. If I work a 10-hour shift, that's going to cost $180. And then I work 14 shifts that month. Well, that's going to cost $2,500 just for that month for me to have a scribe that follows me around and helps me. Well, if you're paid based on salary, the question is, who pays for this $2,500? This could very well be the hospital who pays it for you just to improve your productivity. This could be the group that pays you, but if they have to pay a scribe, they might not give you the bonus that they were going to give you. Or in independent contractor setting, the doctor himself pays for that salary. So $2,500, it's a lot of money to cough up, and that's per doctor per month. So just doing that math again, for a year of me having a scribe, that's $30,000. So the question is, do I want to give up $30,000 of my yearly income to pay for a scribe, or do I just want to take an hour after my shift every day and do my charts? It all depends on what you want. You want quality of life, and $30,000 is not that big of a deal. Then you can go ahead and pay for it, or sacrifice part of your income to get that. But if $30,000 means whether or not your kid's going to get braces, or you're going to go on vacation, or something like that, or make the payment on your whatever RV for vacationing, then it does make a difference. So and the other thing is, that's $30,000 per doctor. So if I have four doctors for a facility per day, So that's $120,000 a year that particular hospital scribe program is going to cost. Let's say I'm in a big emergency group, and then the cost is, I have three facilities who also use scribes. So the cost is, $120,000 times three, that's $300,000 is change, So in the old group I used to be, we have a scribe program, and between the combined facilities and how many scribes we were using, it was costing us about $1 million a year just to have scribes. Now, is that money that you do recover? The argument is yes, because your charts are so much more complete that you actually improve your billing, you improve your collections from non-billable charts or charts that were incomplete and things like that. And then the actual getting critical care time, having the required elements you need for appropriate billing of that chart, the truth is that whoever pays the doctors, whoever's doing the collection of the money for that visit, is going to get their money back and maybe some in return. Plus, the doctors are going to be happier, they're going to leave on time, the work and the ER is going to be better, they're going to have reminders of the things they need to do or not. So I definitely believe that scribes is awesome. The bottom line question is, who's going to cough up the money? And so right now in my emergency department, so we have independent contractors who are paid hourly. So the question is, if we're going to give a bonus or we're going to improve their salary by $20 an hour, so do we take those $20 an hour in the form of scribes, or do we give the doctors $20 and they figure out their charting? Whenever we've given doctors the option to choose $20 or scribe, they choose the $20. But then they'll complain about charting. So there's no way to gain. Now, some of the doctors are so big onto this scribe thing that they are willing to pay out of their own pocket. And I think that's where this is gonna move a lot into. Now, in our emergency department, what I'm trying to do is hire one scribe who will not act as a scribe in the sense that they're not gonna follow the doctor around and write on the computer just one-on-one. But they're gonna act as transcriptionists, gonna go back to paper, write on notes, and then we're gonna feed those notes into a secretarial position, usually a college kid or a pre-med student or even a medical student who works and is paid per hour, to transfer those paper notes into the EMR, emergency medical record, and then put it in. The cost savings are humongous, because instead of hiring four scribes a day, you're hiring one scribe a day. So instead of 46 hours of scribe coverage, or however that is, we only pay for 12 hours. So it's a fourth of the cost. So if we calculate out $30,000 a year for one doctor for 1 year of scribe, then it's $8,000, instead. I will try it out. We'll do it during the daytime hours, and we'll see how that works. I will update on that project and see how it goes. Right now, it's not set up. We're not doing it yet, but we will soon. And I hope that talk explains about scribes and stuff like that. The other thing I wanted to say was, if you're a pre-medical student or college student and you're thinking a career in medicine, this is a great way to get your clinical time, one-on-one of a doctor, get a great letter of recommendation, and learn a lot of medicine, being a scribe for an emergency medicine group. So that's it. Bye-bye.